Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Tonight, a Times Now deep investigation will nail the nefarious global plot that India has been suspecting all along. Our crack team, working under Hector Kenneth, executive editor, has traced leads provided by the anti-India toolkit that several global influencers posted on the social media. Our expose reveals how this sinister propaganda machinery may have used ghost editors to spread misinformation on the Kisan agitation and the Republic Day rampage that eventually followed. For all the opposition leaders who scoffed at Prime Minister Modi's foreign destructive ideology comment, here's a report that will force them to think again. Take a look.
लेकिन ये जो नया एफडीआई आज नजर का आ रहा है, ये नए एफडीआई से जरूर बचना होगा और ये नया एफडीआई है फॉरेन डिस्ट्रक्टिव आइडियोलॉजी.
The opposition of India must watch this and understand why Prime Minister Modi may not be off the mark when he cites foreign destructive ideology targeting India's unity. Times Now's global investigation exposing a sinister trail. Times Now team began first with the UK toolkit trail. Moments after Greta Thunberg tweeted the original toolkit, people observed online users live editing the documents. One of those live editors was a person called Marina Patterson, an alleged PR agent with a publication in UK and whose address was shown as Winchester, England. When we visited the said address, much to our surprise, it turned out to be occupied by an individual not in the least bit connected to Marina Patterson or the publication linked to her in the toolkit.
I'm here on the trail of a shadowy online provocateur called Marina Patterson. Now, Patterson is in the headlines because she was caught literally in the act of editing Greta Thunberg, the famous eco-activist's online toolkit, that sort of propaganda manifesto which purported to advise people on how to mount protest in favour of the Indian farmers, but which has also been linked with many of the riots and protests in India over the last few weeks. Now, Patterson is also thought to be heavily linked with the controversial Poetic Justice Foundation, which is an online lobbying group that is rabidly pro farmers movement. However, in the latest twist, Patterson's own alleged home address, which is just up the road here. Well, I went to the address, I knocked on the door, and it was opened by a bemused couple, the Ben family. I put it to them that they were, or at least she was, Marina Patterson. She said, no, absolutely not. I asked if she knew Marina Patterson. She disavowed any knowledge and, of course, claimed absolutely no involvement whatsoever in global eco-politics or the farmers' protests.
Marina Patterson has been allegedly linked to the toolkit because she was spotted live editing the document originally posted by Greta Thunberg and injecting unverified information to suggest that police attacked the protesters, killing many in the process of bringing order. Perhaps the attempt to cover the tracks is to create distance between the editors of the toolkit and its authors, who runs a brand and image consultancy in Canada. Mohd Halliwal, who is a self-professed Khalistan sympathizer, has publicly accepted that his firm authored the toolkit. And here are some questions that arise post-investigation. If toolkit was not a guide to anarchy, what was the need to cover up tracks? Is Marina Patterson a firewall ID to mask other conspirators linked to the toolkit? Was a fake address put out to mask the connection between toolkit author and influencers? And if there was no sinister motive behind the toolkit, why did live editor delete social media profile? Tonight, the cabal that has come out in support of the vicious FDI must answer. Will they continue to be in denial? Bureau Report, Times Now.
And ladies and gentlemen, I want to point out the key takeaways from this investigation that was done by Times Now's special investigative team. The authors of the toolkit operated under a shroud of secrecy without exposing their real identity or their whereabouts. Because this toolkit appeared in a tweet first, put out by Greta Thunberg, which was later deleted. And when the first toolkit was put out, there was live editing that was going on. Now, why is this a matter of secrecy? These anonymous authors first updated the toolkit with fake facts and then faked their digital footprints as well. Our investigation has also found out that the live editors of the toolkit were linked to the creator of the dossier. The document that detailed the modus operandi of an elaborate anti-India plot was authored by Khalistan sympathizer Modh Halliwal, exposed right here on Times Now just a couple of days ago. This Canadian citizen was the one who also endorsed the Red Fort provocateur Deep Sidhu. All the findings by this cracked investigation team of Times Now exposes a web of deceit that proves a foreign destructive ideology that has hijacked this Kisan stir. And this super exclusive expose brings me to one question which I want Nikunj Garg. Nikunj Garg, our internal security editor who's joining me on the show this evening. Nikunj, I want to ask you, if everything was transparent, if this was an organic protest, if there were global people who were worried about the rights of Indian farmers, why was the toolkit first put out, then edited live on social media, then removed, then a second tweet comes up with another toolkit, and the person who was seen editing it has been seen and identified as Ms. Patterson, doesn't even live on the address which is connected and which was put out in the toolkit? Why this shroud of secrecy if everything is an organic concern for Indian farmers?
Absolutely, an organic and above board concern obviously needs no hiding. And the individual concerns whose name have been used for a cyber entity purpose quite clearly, Navika, by now could not have remained unawares of the fact that there was an investigation that was being done by independent media outlets like Times Now and certain other journalists. And they could have either contacted them, put their version out, or at least made their position apropos the farmers' protest and their cyber engagement with these protests clear. None of that has happened. Instead, what we have been able to find out is that a certain cyber entity has been created under the garb of supporting farmers' protest and a hue of protest-related cyber storm attemptedly tried to build up, none of which stands in the real world or world on its two legs. And therefore, the cast, the character, and even the cyber entities are shrouded in such mystery, as you mentioned, that it is almost virtually impossible for any well-meaning journalist doing painstaking groundwork like two of our colleagues did in the United Kingdom. And many of our other colleagues did it from the desk. So quite clearly, there is much more that is unexplained. Quite clearly, that is why the government is saying that there are vested interests in this entire cyber storm that is being attempted to be created to show it as if the farmers' protest is generating so much of sympathy and garnering so much of support in the cyber platforms. There are vested interests that are trying to take advantage of it, according to the government agencies, and spread their own radical pro-Khalistani anti-India separatist ideology under the garb of supporting this agitation. And this is something I am not for a moment saying, because those investigations are yet to be completed, that there is a physical entanglement or physical enmeshment of interest on the ground with the farmers of these Khalistani radical individuals. That will obviously have to be proven by a law enforcement investigation. But in the cyber world, this entanglement has reached such proportion that it is now causing concerns. And instead of trying to sort of create Twitter storm, and instead of trying to drum up artificial support that does not exist through artificial means, these individuals would do much more, would lend much more credence to this entire farm protest if they maintain their original entities and if they're at all completely neutral.
Well, very well put, Nikunj. On the cyber world, the connections are showing in the real world, we'll have to wait for the investigations. And therefore, thanking you, Nikunj Garg, I'll come back to you for more details on investigations that will be revealed by the NIA. But let me ask our panelists today the legitimate question. And the legitimate question today is just one. Can the lobby, can the opposition, and can these so-called Andolan Jeevis still deny the FDI, the foreign destructive ideology conspiracy here on Indian soil? That's the question and the debate. Times Now exposes FDI. That's the hashtag and the debate on the other side.
You're watching the News Hour at 9. Debate number 1 on Times Now. Super Prime Time.
And joining me tonight, Dr. Sudhanshu Trivedi, Member of Parliament and National Spokesperson of the BJP, Sanjay Hegde, Senior Advocate, Ghanshyam Tiwari, Spokesperson of the Samajwadi Party, Dr. Suman Siraman, Political Analyst, Ashutosh, Political Analyst, MC Abbas, Political Analyst. But my first question goes to Dr. Anand Ranganathan, author, and Dr. Anand Ranganathan. I just want to put out two or three facts. Fact number one, Mohd Halliwal has been found out in the past as somebody who has held pro-Khalistan sentiment. It's something that is represented on his Facebook book and a Facebook page. And, you know, he's not denied it. But what he has denied, just after the January 26th Republic Day violence that we saw, that he stood for anything that was fomenting stir or advocating hate. He said, won't advocate stripping of rights, not connected with any celebrity. This was Dhaliwal's Poetic Justice Foundation, which said that. And then today, when Deep is arrested, he comes out and he says, Deep Sidhu, our brother and activist, Deep is arrested, dissent against democracy, land in jail, likely to experience abuse and torture, Mohd Halliwal. If he is not inciting hate, if he is not incited any violence, why is he so worried about Deep Sidhu, again, a pro-Khalistani sympathizer who did what he did to the flag at the Red Fort?
Yeah, good evening, Navika. First of all, congratulations to you and the Times Now team for this important investigation. I think the time has come for us to look beyond the obvious. And, you know, as far as I'm concerned, there is but one foreign destructive ideology that has wrecked every land it has reached the shores of, and that is communism. And all these stock exchanges and brokers now being unearthed gain from this FDI. This anti-science cult that has resulted in the murder of 100 million innocents is the antithesis of Darwinism, in that it abjures competition and empathy. It attracts hateful, incompetent failures in life. It cushions their guilt of destroying things they are incapable of ever building. One must understand, Navika, the thin lines that divide communism, anarchy and revolution are there for a purpose. Hopscotch. These hammerheads have perfected the art of jumping from one square to another. Communism today, anarchism tomorrow, revolution forever. A leftist can never be your true friend because he's deeply embarrassed about eulogizing mass murderers and following a junk ideology. It's a heady mix of inferiority and persecution complex that soon turns to anxiety when the ideas of the cult are rejected by all intelligent humans. His only refuge then is among people of his own tribe. It's a religion. You keep convincing each other that you are correct. What inevitably follows is authoritarianism. Thought control, state control, and then total control. From Lenin to Stalin to Mao to Castro to Che to Pol Pot is the family tree drawn in the blood of millions of innocents. Closer home, the foundation of Indian communism is built on hypocrisy and bloodshed. If one founder, Dange, wasn't writing groveling mercy petitions to the British to get himself released from prison, another EMS, founder EMS was screaming he will wreck Ambedkar's constitution from within. From prohibiting anyone from organizing blood donation camps during 1962 Indochina war, to passing a resolution hailing the Tiananmen Square massacre in which 10,454 innocents were ruthlessly murdered, to perpetrating the brutal Marichapi massacre of 10,000 Dalits, to now zipping up their lips, even as China, their widowed father, now that USSR is dead, has interned 105 million Muslims in concentration camps. 1.5 million Muslims is orchestrating during their systematic rape and torture, jailing hundreds of Muslim writers and journalists, imposing forced mass sterilization on them, feeding them pork and alcohol, but not a word. Navika, 20 seconds. No wonder Dr. Ambedkar said, quote, "The theory that communism and free democracy can work together seems to me to be utterly absurd, for communism is like a forest fire. It goes on burning and consuming anything and everything that comes in its way. It is absolutely impossible for me to keep relations with the communists. I am an implacable enemy of the communists," unquote. There is no cure for this foreign destructive ideology called communism, Navika. It can only be defeated through herd immunity.
But then I want to ask you, Dr. Anand Ranganathan, is there anything to differentiate between the communists in India and the Congress and the Samajwadi Party? Because all of them today are an anti-Modi force, and therefore ideology of communism, ideology of left-leaning thought processes is something all of them wear on their sleeves. Can you deny that they're all cut from the same cloth today? There is nothing called pure communism anymore.
As I said, Navika, it is a game they are playing, and this game is that, you know, Stapu you used to play hopscotch. That is what it is. These squares that used to define communism, anarchism, socialism, all these things, they've kind of blurred. They are jumping from one to another just in order to destabilize this country and see that when India fails, they can say Modi has failed. That's all there is.
Mr. Ghanshyam Tiwari, that's why I ask you this question. Do you want India to fail to be able to prove your point that Modi has failed? Will the country as a whole have to pay a price because you are so obstinate and you're so involved in your political paradigm of your fight against Narendra Modi that even a plot like this isn't evident to you? You know, why would anybody hide their digital footprint, hide their addresses, lie on the toolkit and use these kind of toolkits to try and foment trouble in a country where largely we are a country which is aspirational and wanting to move ahead?
Well, I believe, Navika ji, the power of India is our democracy, our thought leadership, our diversity and the unity with which this diversity stands. And this power is visible when a Caravan magazine, for example, wins the Nieman Award. And on the same day, this government decides to argue with the magazine in the Supreme Court against the magazine because they want people from the magazine arrested. This diversity also gets under threat. This democratic freedom also gets under threat when NewsClick is raided upon. Why was NewsClick raided upon? You take any index which India is proud of, where press freedom index in the last 7 years, did India go up in press freedom, come down? Hunger index, women in labor force, any form of democratic index.
If we elect a government where the prime minister goes and says, I am here for the parliament, and in last 7 years, there have been more Sundays than the sittings of the parliament, what does it tell about the democratic intent of this government? Then the Prime Minister, who represents Bharatiya Janata Party as a political leader as well, he goes and does Astibat Tam Sarkar. His party becomes a foreign agent in USA. And without a debate, his party shamelessly passes a bill in Parliament that allows foreign companies to donate Chanda, as Akhilesh said, Chanda Jeevi Party. Chanda to Bharatiya Janata Party and such political parties. They corner more than 90% of donations. What does it speak? It is the Prime Minister who believes that his international fame is more important than the policies of this country. And today when his international fame is under attack, they are seeing red. They see conspiracy with Chai. He came to power on the power of Chaiwala. And today he's seeing international conspiracy on Chai because it benefits him in Assam.
No.
They see conspiracy.
Ghanshyam Tiwari, you say he is seeing conspiracy in Chai. Haven't you seen the rule book that has been put out by this foundation of Mohd Halliwal? Poetic Justice Foundation is what it calls itself. And it says, attack yoga, attack chai. Aap keh rahe Prime Minister ko dikhta hai, aapko dikhta nahi hai. आपको ये नहीं दिखता कि ये जो फॉरेनर्स इन्वॉल्व थे, जो टूल किट डाल रहे थे और लाइव उसको एडिटेड कर रहे थे और उसमें लिख रहे थे कि सेलिब्रिटीज को लाना चाहिए, फलाने को लाना चाहिए और हमें वायलेंस क्रिएट करनी चाहिए, रेड फोर्ट पे जाना चाहिए, ये आप कह रहे हैं प्रधानमंत्री को दिखता था, आपको नहीं दिख रहा है? आपको बिल्कुल नहीं दिख रहा? आपने काला चश्मा लगा रखा है या आंखें बंद कर रखी है?
इंडिया प्रोड्यूसर्स नोबेल लॉरेट सच एज प्रोफेसर अभिजीत बनर्जी, प्रोफेसर अमर सुसेन, दिस गवर्नमेंट वुड नॉट लिसन टू. डू वी लुक एट दीज टॉल थॉट लीडर्स एज एज पीपल हु आर टॉर्च बेयरर्स ऑफ इंडिया, और डू वी लुक एट इडियट फ्रॉम अक्रॉस अक्रॉस द ग्लोब हु आर ट्वीटिंग और सेइंग समथिंग अगेंस्ट इंडिया? इट इज फॉर अस टू चूज हु वी वांट टू स्ट्रेंथन.
All right. All right. Then let me, you know, your words, not mine, but Dr. Sudhanshu Trivedi, he says, you're not listening to Amartya Sen or Abhijit Banerjee. He's calling some people who are idiots. I want to ask you, is he also referring to those in the UPA who put in their manifesto the new farm laws which have been rolled out by your government? Is he also calling idiots to Amrinder Singh government, which asked an expert committee headed by Montek Singh Ahluwalia to give out a report which said that these farm laws, whatever form they've come out, exactly what they wanted to do? Are these people also idiots that Mr. Ghanshyam Tiwari is referring to?
I just want to say one thing. If IMF is saying something and our opposition friends are totally denouncing it, okay, then who was Mr. Ashok Gulati, who has been made the chairman of the CACP, who decided the agriculture product in year 2011 by Manmohan Singh government? But suddenly his statement or his opinion become rubbish, but suddenly unko achha kya lagne lagta hai, Rehana ka tarana aur Mia Khalifa? Then who is idiot, sir? Whom you are referring as idiot? और जिसको सुर साम्राज्ञी लता मंगेशकर, भारत रत्न, महाराष्ट्र गौरव के सुर में तो दबाव नजर आता है और रेहाना के तराना में लगाव नजर आता है, अब कौन इडियट है? आप कभी प्रबुद्ध जन है, खुद तय कर लीजिए. एंड नाउ आई वुड लाइक टू एड व्हाट आनंद रंगनाथन हैज सेड. नाविका, इन द लास्ट वन ईयर वी हैव विटनेस्ड टू मूवमेंट्स विच आर घोस्ट मूवमेंट. वाई? देर वॉज नो लीडर टू इट, देर वॉज नो बेस टू इट. When Hegde ji would have got to Shaheen Bagh, Shaheen Bagh ke representative aate the TV channels pe. Supreme Court ke bhejne par bhi koi baat karne ko nahi tha. Farmers movement mein bhi koi nahi hai. Ek ki alambardari kaun kar rahe the? So called Chaklo Brigade. Achha, chehre ek hi the. Ab ye kaise farmers ki baat? Just my dear learned friend, name a single communist country in the entire history of the world jahan democracy kabhi rahi ho. Aaj teen countries hain. Cuba, North Korea and China. And name just six Muslim countries out of the 57 Muslim countries jahan pe democracy ho. Second thing, name a single Muslim country in which the Communist Party is not banned. They are banned to operate. And name a single communist country in which the mosques are not blown by the cannon. Top laga ke udai na gayi ho. यहां पे दोनों आके जब कहते हैं डेमोक्रेसी, फ्रीडम ऑफ स्पीच, एंड एडिंग टू व्हाट आनंद रंगनाथन हैज सेड, सबसे ज्यादा जेनोसाइड अपने लोगों करवाया तो लेफ्टिस्टों ने और मुस्लिम कंट्रीज ने. फंडामेंटलिस्ट आइडियोलॉजी, आई एम नॉट टॉकिंग अबाउट द एंटायर मुस्लिम कम्युनिटी, द फंडामेंटलिस्ट ऑफ द मुस्लिम. और दोनों यहां आकर कहते हैं आहा, हम तो शांति के प्रतीक, हम तो सेक्युलरिज्म के प्रतीक, हम तो स्पीच के प्रतीक. तो समझ में आता है ये डिस्ट्रक्टिव आइडियोलॉजी है क्या. और मैं एक और बात कहना चाहता हूं, एस्टैब्लिश फार्मूला, सेवरल आपने भी कहा फॉरेन के डोनेशन लेने का. घनश्याम जी, मित्रोकिन जारगाइज के जी बी इन द वर्ल्ड पार्ट टू पढ़िएगा, या मैं लगना अल्बर्टस की किताब स्टेट विद इन द स्टेट पढ़िएगा, रूस के पूर्व जासूस जो जर्नलिस्ट के रूप में भारत में रहता था यूरू बेचनेव की किताब पढ़िएगा, कौन पार्टी कितनी बिकी हुई थी. एंड दे आर हैविंग अ सिस्टमेटिक मैथोलॉजी. नंबर वन, फर्स्ट स्टेज ऑफ डिमोरलाइजेशन, try to convince every master that everything in your country is wrong, whether it is administration, polity or culture. Then you succeed. Next stage is the stage of destabilization. When you succeed, the next stage is revolution and cure. And third stage is the stage of so-called normalization, pushing communist regime and आप किसी को कुछ बोलने का नहीं होता, कुछ नहीं, सीधी बात, दो बकवास, एक बार कह दिया सुन लो भाई, और किया तो हमारे बहुत से लोग खड़े होंगे इंटेलेक्चुअल जस्टिफाई करेंगे,
और दूसरी विचारधारा कहते हैं जस्टिफाई करने की जरूरत है तो सीधे टोक देते हैं। और यहां भी उन्होंने कहा ठोक दिया था इंदिरा गांधी जी को, मगर इंदिरा गांधी जी की शहादत के ऊपर छाती पीटने वाला कोई नहीं बोला। सर आशुतोष जी आप काफी मुस्कुरा रहे हैं, आपने मुझसे ज्यादा ये चीजें पढ़ी हैं, बता दीजिएगा इसमें से मैंने कोई भी चीज गलत बोली है, जो किताबों के नाम कोई रह गए हो तो एक आध और ऐड कर देता हूं। इन कन्वर्सेशन विद द क्रो और श्वाइजर्स इलस्ट्रेटिव ऑफ द स्विट्जरलैंड, पांच पांच छह छह किताबें पढ़ लीजिए और उसके बाद बता दीजिएगा घनश्याम जी ऑन पार्टी कितनी बिकी हुई थी, कितनी नहीं टोटल बिकी हुई थी कि नहीं, बड़े बड़े पॉलिटिकल डिसीजन जो थे उसी खरीद और बेच के आधार पे हो रहे थे कि नहीं। नहीं तो मैं दर्शकों से कहूंगा आप ये जो मैंने नाम बताए जाके जरा सा एक बार गूगल सर्च कर लीजिएगा, ज्ञान चक्षु खुल जाएंगे।
सुधांशु त्रिवेदी जी जो कि बड़े पढ़े लिखे आदमी थे भारतीय जनता पार्टी ने उनका क्या काया पलट किया है कि उनके अंदर अचानक इंदिरा गांधी की आत्मा आ गई है और वो बिल्कुल उसी तरीके की थियोरी दे रहे हैं, उसी तरीके की बातें कर रहे हैं जैसे इंदिरा गांधी जो है वो 1974-75 में कहा करती थी। उनकी नजर में जयप्रकाश नारायण जो सीआईए के एजेंट थे, मुरारजी देसाई सीआईए के एजेंट थे, उनकी नजर में जो नवनिर्माण आंदोलन था वो विदेशी ताकतों द्वारा किया गया था, फॉरेन हैंड उसमें इन्वॉल्व था। बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया आपका सुधांशु त्रिवेदी जी, 40 साल में हिंदुस्तान बदला है, लेकिन इतना बदल गया है कि भारतीय जनता पार्टी के प्रवक्ता अब इंदिरा गांधी के प्रवक्ता हो गए हैं और इंदिरा गांधी के जो प्रवक्ता हो गए हैं वो भारतीय जनता पार्टी के प्रवक्ता हो गए और सुधांशु त्रिवेदी के अंदर और भारतीय जनता पार्टी के प्रवक्ताओं के अंदर इंदिरा गांधी के प्रवक्ताओं की आत्मा आ गई है। तो बहुत बहुत मुबारक हो आपको, हिंदुस्तान ने वाकई में 2021 के अंदर
आशुतोष जी आप एज यूजुअल सरफेस की चीजें देखेंगे या आप थोड़ा गहरा भी देखेंगे? और गहराई में मैं आपको बता दूं कि ये जो सोशल मीडिया था ये इंदिरा गांधी जी के जमाने में नहीं था। सोशल मीडिया से किस तरह, हाउ डू यू कुक एंड हाउ डू यू क्रिएट अ सिस्टम ऑफ डिससैटिस्फैक्शन दैट सुधांशु जी रेफर टू टुडे इज अ केस स्टडी। You can see that in the Shaheen Bagh protest, you can see that now in the farmer protest, and you can see how these celebs have come in, and you can see people who were editing, how they have given misleading and completely shrouded in secrecy kind of addresses of their own. And I want to ask you, Ashutosh ji, hand on your heart, you don't see a plot in all this? Ye aapko dikhta nahi hai ya ye aapko ek mazak lagta hai?
नहीं, आपके नेशनल सिक्योरिटी एडिटर ने एक बहुत अच्छी बात की और मैं मुतमईन उनकी बात से, मुतमईन इस बात को लेकर यह हूं कि जो सिक्योरिटी एजेंसीज है वो ये देख रहे हैं कि इस आंदोलन का एडवांटेज लेने की कोशिश की जा रही। जब तक बात इस लेवल पे तब तक तो मैं आपकी राय से सहमत हूं, तब तक मैं सुधांशु जी की राय से भी सहमत हूं। लेकिन अगर सुधांशु जी, उनकी पार्टी और उनकी सरकार ये कहने की कोशिश करेगी कि जो किसानों का आंदोलन है ये दरअसल एक विदेशी साजिश है और ये जो किसान जो आंदोलन पर बैठे हुए हैं ये दरअसल एक विदेशी साजिश के कहने पर बैठे हुए हैं, तो फिर मुझे इस पर ऑब्जेक्शन है। हाँ, ये मैं मान सकता हूं कि किसानों का जो आंदोलन है इसका इस्तेमाल खालिस्तानी करने की कोशिश कर रहे हैं, इसका इस्तेमाल ISI करने की कोशिश कर रही है, इसका इस्तेमाल पाकिस्तान करने की कोशिश कर रहा है, इसका इस्तेमाल चाइना करने की कोशिश कर रहा है और इसका इस्तेमाल कुछ बेवकूफ टाइप के लोग जो कनाडा के अंदर बैठे वो करने की कोशिश कर रहे हैं। लेकिन सुधांशु त्रिवेदी जी अपने दिल पर हाथ रखिएगा और कहिएगा कि क्या ये किसानों का आंदोलन ये पाकिस्तान स्पॉन्सर्ड है, क्या ये किसानों का आंदोलन खालिस्तान स्पॉन्सर्ड है, क्या ये किसानों का आंदोलन विदेशी स्पॉन्सर्ड है? अगर आपके अंदर हिम्मत है तो इस चैनल पर आके कहिए और टंके की चोट पर कहिए और उसके बाद आर्मी लगा के उनको हटाइए वहां से, क्योंकि देशद्रोहियों को इस देश के अंदर आंदोलन करने का अधिकार नहीं। लेकिन मैं जानता हूं आप इंदिरा गांधी की जुबान बोल रहे हैं, उन्हीं इंदिरा गांधी की जुबान बोल रहे हैं जो हर मामले
आधी,
में फॉरेन
आधी बात से तो ये सहमत है आशुतोष जी, लेकिन सुधांशु त्रिवेदी बाकी बात आपको इनको प्रूव करनी है।
हाँ, मैं प्रूव करके बताता हूँ। पहली बात तो मैं आशुतोष जी को बहुत साधुवाद दूंगा, इन्होंने इंदिरा जी को झूठा साबित कर दिया कि वो झूठी थी और उनकी सरकार बहुत घटिया काम कर रही थी, देशभक्तों पे देशद्रोह के आरोप लगा रही थी। धन्य है आप, आपने बहुत अच्छा कार्य किया, साधुवाद। नेक्स्ट थिंग, आपने कहा कि अब मैं ये कह रहा हूं, मैं नहीं कह रहा हूं कि आंदोलन उनके द्वारा स्पॉन्सर्ड है। द फॉरेन डिस्क्रीट निफेरियस इंस्ट्रूमेंट हैव यूज्ड दिस आंदोलन, जैसे हर आदमी अपने अंदर वुहान की लैब लेके नहीं चल रहा कोरोना की, ये बाहर से वायरस घुस जाता है सर, इसलिए मास्क लगा के रखो, हाथ धो के रखो, मगर ना आप हाथ की धुलाई कर रहे हैं और ढिलाई अलग से करते जा रहे हैं, तो वायरस घुस गया है सर। हमने ये नहीं कहा कि आपने वायरस बनाया है, और आपने एक्सेप्ट कर लिया कि वायरस घुस गया है तो घुस गया है, तो फट से आंदोलन छोड़िए, अस्पताल में एडमिट होकर इलाज कराइए।
Well, let me get in Sanjay Hegde. One minute, Ashutosh ji. Sanjay Hegde, I'm asking you that nobody is saying that there wasn't a protest to begin with. But these protests have been hijacked is now very clear from the evidence that is coming out. Otherwise, why would there be a Mo Dhaliwal who till yesterday said he had no connection with anything that was happening in India and in Delhi, but today comes out and says that Deep Sidhu is actually somebody who's being targeted? Why, sir?
See, as the others have said, there has been a protest, and that protest is not limited to the Punjabi farmers alone. You have a whole series of people from Western UP, again, largely belonging to one community, who are also on protest. Our problems are our problems within the country. And when we have problems, somebody else will try to play on them. But unless you solve it within the country, you will not succeed in keeping the outsider away. I'm slightly older than most people out here. I do remember in the days of the Punjab agitation, it didn't start all at once. In 1982, we had the Asian Games. Sikhs traveling through Haryana were interrogated and whatnot. That created an atmosphere of resentment, which then went on to the events of 1984. Do not magnify local disturbances and give too much of a handle to outsider. Solve your problems here itself.
So who's preventing?
And I've been saying it.
Who's preventing the problems to be solved? Because the farmers who were ready for talks, did 11 rounds of talks, ultimately came back to the same position. We will not talk unless these farm laws are repealed. And the government had even offered to put the farm laws aside for 18 months. So I'm asking you, clearly, somebody is playing on the emotions possibly of these farmers and trying to play them against their own country, using this and asking them that and Mo Dhaliwal's statements, his brochure which talks about the dossier that talks about spreading this entire issue through the social media. And Anand Ranganathan, tell me if I'm wrong, because he said
our protest does not end
when the laws are repealed. Our protest begins at that point in time. That's the telltale sign.
Navika, just listen to me. See, you may have 11 rounds.
Yes, absolutely.
Talks, but you may not
and
have
you know the fact of the matter is.
Each time I come in, Anand Ranganathan may think he is talking to me, but we don't have a conversation. It can happen 11 times, it can happen 12 times. Unless you listen to people, there is no conversation. Go ahead.
You were completing your point. You complete your point
now,
and then Anand comes in.
Yeah, thank you, Mr. Hegde. Navika, what is the point?
Allow Sanjay Hegde to make his point and I'm coming to you, Anand Ranganathan. You can take off from there.
My point is simple.
Sure.
You have not had a serious conversation.
Ahead.
What you've had is people talking at each other. Talk to each other. In the 11 rounds, you had Piyush Goyal threatening the farmers with EDA notices. We know who you are. All those things have happened. You have had instances when farmers refuse to eat with the other side. So therefore, please bring down temperatures,
okay,
talk to people.
Okay.
Otherwise,
so Anand Ranganathan, he says that it is the fault of the government. In fact, I don't remember ED word being used at all, but that is the predetermined position that the anti-Modi group really thinks was said. But the fact is that every time an offer was made, every time the government gave up something in that law, the farmers refused to buy it. By the bait. They just said repeal the laws. What does that show? That the opposition is egging them on, and so are those who are taking advantage outside India's frontiers.
No, and absolutely, Navika, but this is utterly bizarre. because you can have 10,000 conversations. The point is, you are having a conversation right now with someone who agreed with you before he did a U-turn. So how on earth is he going to agree with you? All these farm bills, farm reforms were in the manifestos. I mean, Shiromani Akali Dal is a prime example. It was an ally of the government. It agreed, it praised these farm bills. And then it quit the government. It did a U-turn. Same with everyone else. So you can't wake a person pretending to be asleep. These protesters have an agenda. And the agenda is that they cannot be shamed enough because they have realized they were hypocritical. They were for these reforms. How can you communicate more?
That's
I mean, you
point.
Want to show the Congress its own manifesto?
Reforms,
you want to show
Aam
Aadmi Party its own
manifesto? They put it in their manifestos. The Akali Dal government even passed it in Punjab in 2013. But today decided to walk out of this government because all of them want just one thing. And that one thing is scoring a point in their politics. If in the bargain, they hand an advantage to anti-India forces, secessionist forces, so be it, because their politics is above national interest. We'll come back to this debate. I'm slipping into a short break. When I come back, Suman Sriraman and MC Abbas. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. And I'm getting some news. Internal security editor Nikunj Garg joining me at this moment. Nikunj, we understand the NIA is looking at a report and investigations. They've been monitoring and analyzing the social media platforms, including Twitter, Facebook, YouTube, Insta, etc. And they have found a plot that is being worked against India. Can you give our viewers the details of the plot and what NIA has found so far?
Well, Navika, there are two reports that they have drawn. Part of it obviously would be the part of the material that would be, we would be supplying to the United States Department of Justice when our teams land there in April to try and extradite for in a very, very long time some Khalistani cyber terrorists, as they are being called now, including Gurpatwan Singh Panun, who heads the Sikhs for Justice. In the material, the report that they have drawn, their conclusion is that under the garb of garnering support and drumming up support for the farmers' protest, what the radical, separatist, anti-India Khalistani groups, particularly Dal Khalsa and Sikhs for Justice has been named in this report, are doing is that they are running and diverting the traffic that is coming, that is on various platforms, to the referendum sites that they have specifically created for sites like Referendum 2020, purely Khalistani propaganda backed by Pakistan ISI. So the National Investigation Agency quite clearly sees a larger pattern into it. Again, I go back to my words that in the cyber world, the entanglement is almost complete, and the NIA has pointed it out. There are at least 268 multiple platforms that the National Investigation Agency has also pointed to various platform owners or intermediaries to block. And therefore, in the cyber world, the NIA has no doubt in its mind that there is a concerted attempt by the Sikh Khalistani elements, pro-Khalistani elements, to widen the ambit by drumming up artificially the support by this kind of radical propaganda. In the real life, as I said, the investigations are on, and the word, we will have to wait out for them.
Absolutely. Thanks, Nikunj. And Suman Sriraman, that's my question to you. The evidence is coming out. Of course, we will have to wait for the final word to be said. But there are signs. There are signs, and the new warfare methods are looking at the cyber world. They're looking at the social media platforms to attack India, to create a sense of dissatisfaction. I just want to ask you, when the Prime Minister is referring to foreign destructive ideology, isn't he referring to this attempt by forces outside of India to make capital of the kind of emotions that are being beaten up in India, especially by political parties in the opposition?
Look, Navika, the farmers' protest, something which
should be dealt with purely by the between the government and the farm leaders and the agitators and so on. To think that a few tweets made from abroad can cause disharmony in this country so easily, and to look for a conspiracy behind it, which is an international conspiracy and so on. By the way, I just wanted to tell you, Greta Thunberg's the revised, updated toolkit remains there on Twitter. You can go and read
it's
it.
It's an edited one. attention to detail. My investigation team will take you through the original part of the toolkit and the second part. Don't worry.
No. One second. My point, Navika, my point is very simple. The point really is that the government is constantly sort of looking for conspirators, conspiracy theories, which are actually convenient excuses to cover up the fact that this agitation has gone on now for over 75 days. Now, this is something that the government should have sat down. Yes, 11 rounds of talks have been held. Why is it not 13 or 14 or 15 and an attempt to resolve it be found? I agree with the farm laws. In fact, I support the farm laws. But I still find it strange that, you know, the attempt to paint lakhs of these agitationists or farmers as anti-national elements or Khalistanis or those with some kind of ulterior motive, most of them are not. The vast majority of them are farmers who are protesting. They may be right, they may be wrong, but it is for the government to reach out to them and try to resolve the issue. Instead of, you know, demonizing...
So, Sudhanshu Trivedi ji, the question comes back to your court and the point Suman Sriraman is making is, theek hai, foreign hand hai, to aap control kariye. 73 days ho gaye hain, farmers abhi bhi baithe hue hain. If you don't want other people to take advantage, it's the ball is in your court. You have to find the solution because you are in government and you wear a crown of thorns.
That's what we are saying. That we are not exposing Suman Sriraman ji. वो तो ये Greta Thunberg ने unintentionally कर दिया. वैसे मैं एक बात बताऊँ आपको. इंडिया के जो सॉफ्टवेयर के इंजीनियर्स और बच्चे हैं, दे आर मच मोर इंटेलिजेंट. उनमें से कोई ऐसी बेवकूफी नहीं करता, अच्छे से अच्छे सॉफ्टवेयर बनाते हैं. अब सोच उन्होंने कर दिया, आपको नजर नहीं आ रहा है? ये गुरु पतवंत सिंह पन्नू $3.5 लाख का इनाम कह रहा है जिसने लाल किले पे झंडा फहरा दिया, आपको नजर नहीं आ रहा है?
वाई नॉट
वन सारी बार सुनिए. और एक और बात कहता हूं, सिर्फ एक फूड फॉर थॉट और इंटेलेक्चुअल पर्सन हु आर सिटिंग ऑन माई अपोजिट साइड. सर, ये पंजाब ने एक कंपनी के टेलीकॉम कंपनी के टावर उखाड़ा जाना और फॉरेन कंपनीज जो काम कर रही हैं उनके बारे में कुछ नहीं करना, और बेंगलुरु में दूसरी एक कंपनी के जो एप्पल की कंपनी जो चाइना से शिफ्ट होकर भारत आई है उसी में बवाल हो जाना, आपको इसमें कोई कनेक्शन नहीं नजर आता? या आपको सिर्फ संयोग नजर आता है? अगर संयोग नजर आता है तो थोड़ा और गहराई से देखिए. हाँ, एज फार एज द गवर्नमेंट इज कंसर्न,
गवर्नमेंट इज वर्किंग विद अटमोस्ट केयर, अटमोस्ट सेंसिटिविटी. क्योंकि हम ये ध्यान रखना चाहते हैं, एक हिंदी में कहावत है, गेहूं के साथ घुन का पिसना. वी वॉन्ट टू एंश्योर कि गेहूं के साथ घुन ना पिसे. इसलिए वी आर सेग्रीगेटिंग दोज हु हैव डन रॉन्ग एंड द गवर्नमेंट इज पिन पॉइंटिंग बाई शियर टेक्नोलॉजी. अफसोस यही है ना कि टेक्नोलॉजी ने आपको रुसवा कर दिया, वरना आप तो आंदोलनकारी थे काम के. अब क्या बताएं, सीसीटीवी भी लगा है, ड्रोन भी लगा है, आईपी एड्रेस भी मिल जाता है. बड़ी बड़ी प्रॉब्लम है जब ये नहीं था.
एमसी अब्बास आंदोलनकारी से आंदोलनजीवी बन गए. यही तो प्रोग्रेस हुआ है.
मैं बताता हूँ, मेरे प्रिय मित्र जो हैं, बड़े भाई हैं सुधांशु त्रिवेदी जी और हमारे ऑनरेबल प्राइम मिनिस्टर श्री नरेंद्र मोदी जी, वो स्पीकिंग ऑफ फॉरेन डिस्ट्रक्टिव आइडियोलॉजी. सुधांशु भाई के लफ्जों में कहूँगा मैं, कुछ तो बात है हम में कि मिट्टी नहीं हस्ती हमारी, सदियों रहा है दुश्मन दौरे जहां हमारा. सुधांशु साहब, आंदोलनकारी से आंदोलनजीवी कहते हैं, इज दिस राइट? हु आर वी टॉकिंग अबाउट? द फार्मर्स, द अन्नदाता ऑफ दिस नेशन. सुधांशु जी, ये बात कर क्या रहे हैं आप? कौन है आप लोग और कहां से आते हैं? आदिवासी को नक्सलाइट बताते हैं, कोई स्टूडेंट युवा आ गया उसको एंटी नेशनल, कोई मुसलमान प्रोटेस्ट करे देशद्रोही, कैसी बात कहते हैं आप? और आखिर में सुधांशु त्रिवेदी जी, आपको कह रहा हूं मैं, लेकिन पर्सनली मत लीजिए. जुल्मी जब जब जुल्म करेगा सत्ता की गलियारों से, चप्पा चप्पा गूंज उठेगा इनकलाब के नारों से. ये किसान है खालिस्तानी नहीं, आप खालिस्तानी के साथ कीजिए. और जो मोहिंदर गुलाटी की बात कहते हैं आप, द फॉर्मर यूनाइटेड नेशन सस्टेनेबल एनर्जी चीफ ऑपरेटिंग ऑफिसर, आई सल्यूट यू सर ऑन 3 points. फूड शॉर्टेज इन इंडिया, यस. वाटर क्राइसिस इन इंडिया, यस. क्रॉप रेसिड्यू एमिशन, क्रॉप बर्निंग, यस. देयर नीड्स टू बी अ डायलॉग. बट सर, लाइक यू आर एंटाइटल टू योर ओपिनियन, अ ग्रेटा थनबर्ग 18-year-old activist इज इंडीड एंटाइटल टू हर ओपिनियन. व्हेन अ प्रियंका
nobody is saying she is not entitled to her opinion, but in her opinion, if there is a toolkit that has been put by Mo Dhaliwal, there is a problem in it. Sudhanshu Trivedi, my point is, can they not see it, or are they pretending to be blind and looking the other way?
आपने एनसी अब्बास साहब मेरा पहला स्टेटमेंट नहीं सुना, बड़ा अच्छा आपने बोला, सदियों रहा है दुश्मन दौरे जा, कौन किसका दुश्मन रहा मैंने बताया तो, नेम ए सिंगल मुस्लिम कंट्री इन द कम्युनिस्ट इज नॉट बैन एंड नेम ए सिंगल कम्युनिस्ट कंट्री इन विच द मॉस्क आर नॉट ब्लोन बाय कैनन। दुश्मन तो एक दूसरे के रहे हैं जनाब, हम तो हमेशा सबका साथ देते आए हैं। इसलिए मैं एक और बात भी कहना चाहूंगा, एज फॉर एज ग्रेटर थंडर एंड अदर इज कंसर्न, अरे कोई कुछ भी बोले कोई फर्क नहीं पड़ता है। अफसोस तब होता है जब रेहाना का ट्वीट सुरजेवाला जी कांग्रेस के चीफ ऑफ द मीडिया डिपार्टमेंट ट्वीट करते हैं, तब हमें इस बात का असर होता है। और अभी हेगड़े जी ने देखे कितनी अच्छी बात कह दी, कहां कहां तक जमाना आ गया, उन्होंने कह दिया कि पंजाब क्राइसिस पाकिस्तान स्पॉन्सर्ड नहीं थी, इंदिरा गांधी की गलतियों से हुई। आज देखिए क्या क्या देखने को मिला नाविका जी, इंदिरा जी को झूठा षड्यंत्रकारी बना दिया पहले आशुतोष जी ने, अब हेगड़े जी ने यह कह दिया, और उसके बाद आरोप लगाते। अब चलिए आपने बहुत अच्छा किया जो एक्सपोज कर दिया। एंड फाइनली आई वुड लाइक टू से वन थिंग,
सुधांशु जी
फार्मर्स
ने बात को पहचानते हैं,
एक सेंटेंस
मानते हैं,
एक सेंटेंस से बोल दीजिएगा, किसान
वन मिनट संजय अग्रे आल्सो रेजिंग इज सुधांशु जी कंप्लीट एंड कमिंग टू संजय
किस स्टेट में, आनंद जी को डर किस बात का, किस स्टेट में, पंजाब में,
कैन आई कम इन,
जेल में डालने वाला कानून काला नहीं है,
लेकिन
और जिस पे कोई जेल डालने का स्कोप नहीं वो काला है, बता दीजिए
सत्ता की। दैट्स राइट संजय अग्रे, द Punjab, the Punjab law where there is provision of putting people in jail, that is not a black law. But the law that has been brought in here is without any provision of jail to farmers, yet it is being called the black law. I want to ask you, is there a deliberate attempt to keep this country as a PPP, professional perpetual protesting country?
No, I think the real problem is correctly identifying FDI. What is the government afraid of in FDI? It is afraid of a fully democratic India, an India where people know what their rights are, an India which is refusing to accept bully of any kind, an India which says that, look, we have put you in power for 5 years with a majority, but rule democratically between elections. Do not ride roughshod.
Anand Ranganathan, who's the bully? The opposition that has only one ideology, which is anti-Modi, or is it Modi who's the bully?
That is obvious.
Anand Ranganathan,
I'm afraid we're missing the votes for the trees here. Because, now, Mr. Hegde, this is the second time we're interrupting.
I'm running out of time, Dr. Anand Ranganathan, please.
I didn't interrupt you. Yeah. So, Navika, yes, as I was saying, we are missing the woods for the trees. This is a good old, age-old battle in trying to keep India poor. And how do you keep India poor? Through it remaining socialist. Everything is state-owned. And this is just the first of the agitation, Navika. Congress has already trumpeted that it is going to start against privatization. A huge ruckus, a huge dharna. And if you remember, you see, this country has only progressed because we have repeated successful experiments, not failed ones. Do you know what was, talking of FDIs and foreign reserves, our foreign reserves in 1991 was $600 million, not even $1 billion in 1991. Then P.V. Narasimha Rao constituted the reforms. Right now, our foreign reserves are $600 billion. People are not happy that India is progressing. India is becoming less socialist. So in this garb of socialism and communism, they want India to remain a backward third case basket case.
And are our political parties only adding fuel to the fire? It is almost like saying, if the Congress does privatization, it should be lauded as reforms of the century, a turning point for India. If the Congress puts up in its manifesto modernizing of agriculture through farm laws that were now put out by the Modi government, then they were fine. But if Modi puts them out, they're all wrong and they are the black laws. The very question that this country will need to answer is, who's going to take India forward? And that is something the people of this country will have to decide, whether to be led by them or whether to be misled by the other. Thank you very much to my panelists for joining me on this big debate.